IES files are text files that describe how specific lights look in real life. They are essential for realism in architectural visualization. You can find thousands of them for free online. Once you've downloaded some IES files, add a point light. Click on Use Notes in the light settings. Make sure you've selected cycles, as IES lights don't work in EV. In the shader editor, press Shift A for the Add menu and find the IES texture node. Set it to External and load an IES file in the node. Then connect it to the strength input of the point light. To make the shape of the light distribution more pronounced, you can lower the radius of the light. But be careful, as a radius of 0 can produce some artifacts. I found that a value of 0.02 or 0.03 is a safe range that doesn't produce artifacts but still looks sharp. This kitchen scene was made mostly with assets from Polygon. I've personally used Polygon a lot for doing client work, and I was always able to find what I needed, especially for architectural scenes. Besides materials, they now also have detailed 3D scanned models, like all this delicious looking food. However, I couldn't find any 3D scanned donuts. Add a spotlight and enable Use Nodes in the shader editor. Switch to Rendered View and increase the intensity of the spotlight. Select the Emission node of the spotlight and press Ctrl+T to add texture nodes. Add an image or video texture. In case you're using a video texture, open the Option panel by pressing N. Then click the Match Movie Length icon next to the frame value. Enable Auto Refresh as well. Use normal texture coordinates. In Cycles, you should now see the textured light. To adjust the blurriness, change the light radius value. To have the texture cover a wider area, increase the beam shape spot size value. Set Render Engine to Cycles. In the World tab, set Color to Sky Texture. Set it to Nishita with the Sun Disk enabled. Right away, you get this nice sky background and lighting. Sun Rotation changes the horizontal position of the sun. To make sure there's no light leaking, I added a Solidify modifier to the room. To create a sunset time-lapse, you can set keyframes for the sun elevation value. Just be sure to set the keyframes to linear. Sun size affects the softness of the shadows. The bigger the sun, the softer the shadow. The air, dust, and ozone values control how much the air quality influences the light. Increasing the air value gives more dramatic sunsets. To set up an HDRI manually, go to the World tab. Click on the yellow dot next to Color. Choose Environment Texture. Click on Open and choose an HDRI file. You can get a lot of free HDRIs from polyhaven.com. Now, if you switch to Render Preview, you can see that the HDRI is visible in the background and lighting the scene. If you don't want to see and render the HDRI in the background, you can go to the Render tab and check Transparent under the Film options. In that case, choose a file format which supports transparency, like PNG or EXR, and check RGBA. If you found this topic interesting and would like to know more, don't forget that you can find it in my Blender Secrets ebook, along with almost 2000 pages of other tips. To get an idea of what the ebook is like, you can download the free sample from my website.